with another video on fun math. Today we are going to discuss about a topic in binomial theorem called as greatest term and greatest coefficients. Greatest term. What does the word greatest term in a binomial or binomial expansion mean? The greatest term in a binomial expansion means that the term which is the greatest of all the terms in that expansion. Okay, let's start by proving that. First, let T R plus 1 means R plus 1th term, T R plus 1 and T R be R plus 1th and Rth terms respectively in the expansion of X plus A whole power N. T R plus 1 is the R plus 1th term and T R is the Rth term in the expansion X plus A whole power N. Then T R plus 1 is the R plus 1th term, right? For R plus 1th term, it is a general term in a binomial expansion. It is NCR X power N minus R A power R. Here NCR means it is the combination of n possibilities and R cases. It is the denoting of combination. I hope you know this. If you not, go check out my previous videos. TR plus 1 is the NCR X power N minus R A power R. It is the R plus 1th term and Rth term. Rth term means just replace R minus 1 in place of R in this expansion. So we'll get NC R minus 1 X power N minus of R minus 1 means it is N minus R plus 1 into A power R minus 1. Now if we divide this, N T R plus 1 by T R is NC R X power N minus R A power R by NC R minus 1 X power N minus R plus 1 A power R minus 1. Means that is NC R means it is number of combinations, right? The formula for finding combinations is we check this in previous videos. N factorial by N minus R factorial into R factorial. That is how to calculate the combination. And for NC R minus 1, substitute R minus 1 in place of R, but it is in denominator, right? So we can write that reverse. Means N factorial by R minus 1 factorial into N minus R plus 1 factorial, right? We'll write that reverse. R minus 1 factorial into N minus R plus 1 factorial by N factorial into, and here if you divide these, you'll get A power R means there are RAs. But in denominator, we have R minus 1As, means 1A would be remaining in the numerator. Similarly, in denominator, 1X will be remaining. So, we'll get A by X. Now, here, N factorial and N factorial cancels out. So, you'll get here, N minus R plus 1 factorial means we can divide that into N minus R factorial into N minus R plus 1. We discussed that in properties of combinations. This, and it is the basic formula. If you use factorial, it means that it is the product of numbers from 1 to n minus r plus 1, right? Means it can also be product of numbers from 1 to n minus r into n minus r plus 1. 1 to n minus r means it is n minus r factorial into n minus r plus 1. So here we have n minus r factorial, right? It cancels out. So we'll get n minus r plus 1 in the numerator. And in denominator, R factorial means similarly R minus 1 factorial into R. So R minus 1 factorial cancels out, you will get R remaining into this A by X. This is the formula for TR plus 1 by TR. Now, it means that TR plus 1 is greater than, equal to, or less than TR, right? R plus 1 the term may be greater than or equal to or less than TR plus 1. If you divide by TR on both sides, then you'll get TR plus 1 by TR is greater than or equal to or less than 1. TR by TR means it is 1. minus 1 by tr means it is n minus r plus 1 by r into a by x. It is greater than, equal to, or less than 1. Now here, if we divide this, means n and 1 in one term and this minus r in one term. So I'll get n plus 1 by r minus r by r means it is 1. N plus 1 by r minus 1 into ax is greater than, equal to, or less than 1. Now n plus 1 by r minus 1 means multiply with a by x by a on both sides. Then you'll get n plus 1 by r minus 1 is greater than, equal to, or less than x by a. Now add 1 on both sides. You'll get n plus 1 by r is greater than, equal to, or less than 1 plus x by a. Means now we need r, right? So what can we do to get r? We can cross multiply. Or send r to the RHS and send 1 plus x by a to the LHS. So we'll get n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a is greater than, equal to, or less than r. Means r is less than or equal to or greater than n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a. So tr plus 1 is greater than, equal to, or less than 3tr according as r is less than or equal to or greater than n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a. It is based on this, n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a. Now, okay guys, now we'll have two cases, that is n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a is an integer or not an integer. First, if it is an integer, then let it be equal to m. Then, from equation number 1, what is equation number 1? From equation number 1, what is equation number 1? It is tr plus 1 is greater than, equal to, or less than tr according as r is less than or equal to or n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a. This is equation number 1. Right? Based on that equation, tr plus 1 is greater than tr if r is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on until m minus 1. This is equation number 2. And tr plus 1 is equal to tr for r is equal to m. If r is equal to m, then tr plus 1 is equal to tr. Right? Because this fully is equal to m, right? It is based on if r is less than m, then tr plus 1 is greater than tr. So here it is less than m, right? So it is greater than tr. Tr plus 1 is greater than tr. If those are equal, then tr plus 1 is equal to tr. And if r is equal to m plus 1 and so on until n, means greater than m, then tr plus 1 is less than tr. Now, from equation number 2, t2 is greater than t1, right? t2 is greater than t1. t3 is greater than t2. T4 is greater than T3 and so on until Tm is greater than Tm minus 1. So Tm plus 1 is equal to Tm from equation number 3. And from equation number 4, Tm plus 2 is less than Tm plus 1. And Tm plus 3 is less than Tm plus 2 and so on until Tn plus 1 is less than Tn from equation number 4. Right? Now, okay, what can we conclude from this? Here the greatest term from first is Tm and the greatest term from last is Tm plus 2. Right? So we can conclude that if we take from last, greatest term is Tm plus 1. If we take from first, it is Tm. And those both are equal, right? So both of them are the greatest terms. Now let's take case 2 if it is not an integer. Now tr plus 1 is greater than tr for r in between 1, 2 and so on until m. Okay, here if This is the case too if n plus 1 by 1 plus x by a is not an integer, then let m be the integral part of that function. Then if r is from 1 to and so on until m, or if r is less than m, tr plus 1 is greater than tr, right? M is the fraction, m is the integral part, right? Means it is greater than, it is less than that. N plus 1 by 1 plus x by, it is less than that. So here tr plus 1 will be greater than tr, and tr plus 1 is less than tr for r from m plus 1 and so on until n, where n is the last term. So from equation number 5 means this, t2 is greater than t1, right? t3 is greater than t2 and so on until tm plus 1 is greater than tm. Tm plus 1 is greater than tm. And from equation number 6, tm plus 2 is less than tm plus 1, tm plus 3 is less than tm plus 2 and so on until tn plus 1 is less than tn. Now, that implies T1 is less than T2 is less than T3 and so on until is less than Tm. As you can see here, is less than Tm, and Tm plus 1 is greater than that, means is less, Tm is less than Tm plus 1. And from then onwards, here if you see Tm plus 1 is greater than Tm plus 2, right? Is greater than Tm plus 2, and Tm plus 2 is greater than Tm plus 3 and so on until all are greater than tn plus 1, right? If you observe carefully, the greatest term is m plus 1th term. Tm plus 1 is the greatest term. So m plus 1th term is the greatest term. Now let's see an algorithm to find the greatest term. Step 1, write tr plus 1 and tr for the given expansion. Write r plus 1th term and rth term. And next, write tr plus 1 by tr. Find the value of tr plus 1 by tr. Now, set it greater than 1. Tr plus 1 by tr greater than 1. Means, this is only if you have the rth term in terms of r or n. Put tn r plus 1 by tr greater than 1. Now solve the inequality in this step. For r, to get an inequality of the form r less than m or r greater than m. And if m is an integer, then mth and m plus 1th terms are equal in magnitude, and those are the greatest terms, m and m plus 1th term. And if m is not an integer, then obtain the integral part of m like k. Then k plus 1th term is the greatest term. Okay guys, this is for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you not, comment down below why you haven't. If you have any doubts, comment down below. I'll answer them in the next video.